bitches.
Germany calling. Here are the Reichsender ambush. Station Bremen and station DXB on the 31-meter band. You are about to hear our news in English.
Hello, Mr. and Mrs. America and all the ships at sea. Had it not been for the war, Hitler would have done well. Which is like saying, if it had not been for the Jews, Hitler would have been redundant. Almost without reservation, Lord Hara approved of the man. Hitler's achievements were only now being fully understood. In the mythical identification with which leaders in the West had invested in him, and in the role model France and England and America had found in what they thought was his new conservatism, that these nations had totally misunderstood, both his stance in iron intransigence in the face of adversity, was hardly his fault. History rewrites itself with or without its main protagonist. Unblinking Lord Hara, the English radio broadcaster, gazed out into the fierce Burmese sunlight. It was 7:30 ante meridian. Yet already, though the month was only April, there was a solid humidity in the air. Only the occasional breath of wind blowing in from the ocean, stirring the stems of the newly drenched orchids hanging from the eaves of the station veranda, provided relief. Hara scanned the sky for sign of the airship. His bones felt hollow, and he wiped a clawed hand across his forehead. Another migraine was brewing. He began to hum an old sentimental tune to himself. The words floated in his head like clouds of bee sperm, whilst deeper thoughts awoke in him memories of time long spent.
Of things I should be grateful for, I've had a goodly share.
How intimately strange death is. The more you think about it, the sooner it happens.
And as I sit in the comfort of a cozy chair,
I lapse into a terrible reverie.
My fancy takes me to a humble east side tenement, 3 flights in the rear, where my childhood days were spent.
I think about everyone dying.
It wasn't much like paradise, but amidst the dirt and all, there sat the sweetest angel, one that I fondly call.
We live life to say yes to death.
My Yiddish mama, I need you more than ever now.
We manage to function. The thought of death paralyzes the weak. Its threat deep and real.
My Yiddish mama, I'd love to kiss that wrinkled brow.
We drive a car, we fly a plane.
I long to hold her hand once more, as I did in days gone by.
We live our lives to death's invisible fugue, but by mutual consent, it is something people hide from each other, no more so than in the death camps.
And ask her to forgive me for things I did that made her cry.
True, all true.
How few were her pleasures. She never cared for fashion style. Her jewels and treasures she found amid my baby's smile.
Don't you see the enormity of what's been done?
Oh, I know that I owe what I am today.
Against the chaos of my soul.
To that dear little lady.
The more people you kill, the easier becomes the pain of life. So the theory goes.
So old and gray. To that wonderful Yiddish show. Yiddish show.
We start our lives in chaos, Bubble. It's only fitting that we end it so.